Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to get the numeric value of any letter in the alphabet in Microsoft Excel. So by the end of this video, if I put in the letter C, I should be returned with the number 3 because C is the third letter in the alphabet. And if I put it in A, I should be returned with the number 1.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So in order to get the numeric value of the location of a number throughout the alphabet, so these numbers are 1 through 26, where A is going to be a 1 and Z is going to be 26. We are going to use a function called code. So I'm going to click in B2 and type equals code with a left parenthesis. Now the code I want is from a text value, but I want the text value of uppercase letters only, because if I use uppercase letters only, then all the code is a matter of subtracting 64 to give me 1 through 26 for those alphabetical characters. So in this case, I'm going to type code, but then I'm going to type upper for the uppercase letter of whatever I put in A2. And then I'm going to put another parenthesis, and my text is located right here in A2. So I'm going to click on A2, close my parentheses for the upper function, and then close my parentheses for the code function. So if I were to hit enter right now, I would be returned with a 65. So if I put a B in here, I'd be returned with a 66. So that's not really the letter of the alphabet that I'm looking for. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. But if I click back in B2 and at the end of this function, I do minus 64 and hit enter, I can now see I'm getting a 2 for B, and B right here is lowercase. So even if I come in here and put an uppercase B, I'm still returned with a 2. So let's try Z right here. I am returned with a 26. So I know that this function is now working. Now there are some other ways to do this, such as using the column headers across the top that are built into Excel. And we go over those a lot more out on our blog. And I'm going to include a link to our blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.